Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at the facial profile feature in iClone 8 in Character Creator 4 that allows you to simply apply and switch between different profiles based on the structure and needs of your current character. The facial profile is mainly used as a preset that allows you to quickly apply expressions to CC avatar and humanoid character types. With the newest release, we provided two standard profiles as well as some custom ones, so let's check them out. Normally there are three main types of data in the facial profile: the standard expressions, the custom expressions, and the viseme shapes. The standard expression template set is provided and has already been defined. It includes the CC4 standard and CC4 extended profiles. The standard profile includes 60 blend shapes and is useful for characters that don't need micro details in their facial animation and also for basic facial mocap. The extended profile has a whopping 140 blend shapes and is useful when you need more subtle and detailed animation that utilizes the small details. The custom expression profile is provided for your custom blend shapes that you can import and use to create your own facial profile, most often useful for custom characters that you've imported. Viseme blend shapes are used for lip sync animation. There are a total of 15 blend shapes dedicated to visemes, which represent the shape of the mouth made when speaking a specific sound. There are 7 tongue blend shapes as well that combine with other visemes to create a completely accurate lip sync. We will have more tutorials that go into a lot more detail in terms of utilizing all of these shapes and achieving the most accurate lip sync. Okay, let's get started with a legacy CC avatar character from a prior version. In order to find out which facial profile this character is utilizing, we can go to the Modify panel under the Animation tab and find the Facial Profile Editor. The Facial Profile Editor is the tool used to utilize your character's facial blend shapes and is only available in Character Creator 4. To get started, let's enter into Edit Expression editing mode via the button at the top. We can see on the left that this character is using the traditional facial profile. The facial parts listed underneath make up those of the standard expression profile, where there is also a custom item below where the custom expressions will appear. The viseme profile for this character is utilizing the 8+7 phoneme pair, which utilizes tongue blend shapes to enhance the lip sync result. Although the traditional profile is for CC3 and iClone 7, you can still use them in the current versions if you choose to. The traditional profile also contains custom expressions, which are associated with the Apple ARKit blend shapes. You can learn more about this in our iClone 7.9 facial mocap tutorials. Okay, let's look at changing the facial profile now. You'll find your facial profile subcategory under Actor. Notice that the profiles I mentioned earlier are already here, including traditional, custom, and some CC4 profiles. This current character is using the CC3 Plus traditional facial profile. What I'm going to do next is apply the CC4 standard profile to our character. As mentioned before, the standard profile includes 60 blend shapes and is suitable for animating humanoid and stylized toon-like characters, as well as doing facial mocap. The extended profile contains 140 blend shapes and is used for precise facial animation like you will find in a higher budget, realistic film or game project. Once I apply the standard profile, a dialog box will pop up asking which elements of our template I'd like to apply. You'll notice two additional items, keep eye blink and jaw open. This is provided as eye blinking and jaw opening variables may be different depending on bone size. Be aware that in the CC4 standard profile, there is no custom expression data included. I'm going to leave everything as is and just apply. Once we do, back in the standard expression section, you'll see the facial parts will be different, and you can play around with the various blend shapes in each facial category to test them out. Note that it still uses the same 8+7 phoneme pair viseme profile. Let's take a look at how we can control the different profiles now. While the Facial Profile Editor is a definitive tool for defining blend shapes, if you want to perform custom expressions, it's recommended that you use the Edit Facial tool, which can be found in the Animation tab. Once we enter into that tool, you'll see that it also shows the facial profile at the top. Different facial profiles will provide different control options. With a traditional profile, you can switch the control profile to either EX Plus or EX Plus Tongue, aside from the default one. With EX Plus, you have a number of different muscles you can control individually by selecting them, then clicking and dragging to help build the expression. Speaking of expressions, there are some template ones that you can also find in the Expression tab, and their strength can be adjusted using the Expressiveness slider at the top. With the CC4 standard facial profile, the control dummy is similar to the traditional one, but you'll also have the option to adjust the tongue as well. In addition, the expressive performance will be a lot more vivid and interesting. Finally, you can see the CC4 extended profile, which contains the most control points for controlling facial features. With the extended profile, previously unexplored areas like the neck can now be controlled to exaggerate expressions like surprise or anger. The corneas can also be adjusted to add that nice little touch to the expression as well. The lips have a great amount of detail and can be controlled in 4 different coordinates. Overall, the extended profile is just more precise than the standard one in many ways. If you want to animate your character, you'll definitely want to look into iClone 8, which contains a powerful array of motion tools for both face and body. The facial puppet tool is a legacy animation tool in iClone that can create quick animations with simple mouse movements. You'll notice that it will detect the facial profile at the top automatically. There are a ton of puppet profiles to choose from that are compatible with both standard and extended profiles. Once you choose one, you can click on Preview and press the space key to test it out with the movement of your mouse. You can also puppet separate parts of your character's face individually as well, using profiles, to add subtle touches to features like the lips and brows. You can record these separately and layer them on top of each other in various combinations for all kinds of unique results. One final important thing to note is that the specific facial profiles can only be applied to characters that share the same base or topology. For example, if I try to apply these other custom profiles to my coyote character, I'll get an error. That's about it for this tutorial, guys. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel and Learning Center for tons more tutorials on both facial animation and a variety of other topics. I'll see you in the next video.